ब्रह्मादिभ्यो ब्रह्म विद्या संप्रदाय कर्तृभ्यो वंश ऋषभ्यो महद्भ्यो नमो गुरुभ्यः सर्वोपप्लवरहित प्रज्ञान घन प्रत्यगर्थो ब्रह्माहमस्मि सोहमस्मि ब्रह्माहमस्मि। ओम प्रपन्न पारिजाताय तोत्र वेत्रैकपाणये ज्ञान मुद्राय कृष्णाय గీతామృతదుఖే నమః. ఓం నమో వెంకటేశాయ. మై బెస్ట్ విషెస్ అండ్ పరిపూర్ణ ఆశీర్వాదంస్ టు ఆల్ ద వ్యూవర్స్ ఆఫ్ శ్రీ వెంకటేశ్వర భక్తి ఛానల్. మే ద ఆల్ మైటీ శ్రీ లార్డ్ వెంకటేశ్వర బెస్టో ఆల్ కైండ్స్ ఆఫ్ ప్రాస్పరిటీ, హెల్త్, వెల్త్ అండ్ ఎటర్నల్ హ్యాపీనెస్ విత్ పరిపూర్ణ లక్ష్మీ కటాక్షంస్ టు యూ అండ్ యువర్ ఎంటైర్ ఫ్యామిలీ మెంబర్స్. లెట్ అస్ బిగిన్ భగవద్గీత వర్డ్స్ నంబర్ 7 ఆఫ్ 6th చాప్టర్. శ్రీ భగవాన్ ఉవాచ జితాత్మన ప్రశాంతస్య పరమాత్మా సమాహితః శీతోష్ణ సుఖ దుఃఖేషు తథా మానాపమానయోః. భగవాన్ కృష్ణ హ్యాస్ మెన్షన్డ్ దేర్ ఆర్ టూ కైండ్స్ ఆఫ్ ప్రిపరేషన్స్ ఫర్ మెడిటేషన్, అంతరంగ సాధనాని బహిరంగ సాధనాని. బహిరంగ సాధనాని మీన్స్ ద మీన్స్ ఫ్రమ్ ద ట్రాన్సాక్షన్, ద మీన్స్ విత్ ద బాడీ మైండ్ అండ్ సెన్స్ కాంప్లెక్స్, బికాస్ ద మెడిటేషన్ హ్యాస్ ద టూల్ నథింగ్ బట్ ద మైండ్ అలోన్. దెర్ఫోర్ వీ నీడ్ టు హ్యావ్ అ వెరీ స్ట్రాంగ్ అండ్ కామ్ ద మైండ్ విచ్ ఇస్ ఎండౌడ్ విత్ పీస్ఫుల్నెస్. Now in previous days in ancient India we had a Gurukula system. In the Gurukula, Guru used to be there. When Shishya comes, Guru diagnoses what the disease, where the problems is. The finding the locus of error is very important. Like in those days, when you go to doctor will check the pulse and he will read your nadi where the disease exists. But recent days you have to tell what is going on, because diagnosis is not easy thing. Though we have so many equipments, methodology, but proper diagnosis will be the 50% remedy. In the same way, when you want to get the growth in the spiritual life, you need to have a proper person who could diagnose the disease called Bhavaroga. Now we are not getting the Gurukula system at present. Then what to be done? The gurus used to follow certain method. They ask a student or disciple to work for ashrama duty. He will be provided loads of duty, taking care of the cows and the kitchen job or something, you know, cleaning job or some construction or to take care of agricultures. So these activities will help. In these activities he can become mature. He can utilize the karma yoga, buddhi yoga to become mature about it. That's what said first preparation. The best way to prepare yourself with your sensory organs, I mean to become master over your sense organ, the karma yoga is the best way. Therefore, from the third, fourth, Bhagavan Krishna has given solid knowledge about karma and karma yoga. By adapting those karma yoga in our life, we can become matured. The first, he said, to have the balanced mind, because mind is filled with emotions. Without emotions, there is no life. Because emotions are valuable tools for our life, we need to experience certain emotions. Even I found certain people who lived alone, they were even craving for the emotions. Mind needs certain emotions. Therefore, you know, we are not able to sit silent in our home. If we don't have anything to do, we would like to call somebody and talk somebody and what is going on. Otherwise, we change the channels, what is going on. So we want to entertain. Mind needs to be entertained with emotions. Many times minds becomes high and down because of emotions. Therefore, we need to have a mind which doesn't have the layers. The mind which could maintain peacefulness during the job. But when you are not preparing like this, but you are sitting for the meditation, the impact will affect you. Our body and mind and sense complex to be trained has to be trained during the action. So when there is an action, the action will help us to explore. Explore means to express your emotions. So when you express something, when you do something, if you are little bit aware enough, you could organize your sense and your ability. The way you speak, the way you do, the performance will become organized. Now you see, now you are started doing meditation during the job itself. That's what known as karma yoga. First, you focus on your karma. You organize your mind through the karma. That was the first step. The second step Bhagavan Krishna introduced was self-effort. So one should be endowed with self-effort. Without self-effort, nothing can be achieved. One should be with confident and self-effort. Or we can also count confident also a qualifications, that also can be a step. Confident, you have to be confident. You know, many people I have seen, they tell, you know, Ramana Maharishi, he is an extraordinary soul. And Swami Vivekananda, he is a special. Swami Ramakrishna, he was special. Ramanuja, Adi Shankara, and even Madhva, and all the rishis, Nayanmars, Alvars, all of them were special. They were a special souls. I am an ordinary, normal person. For me, all those spiritual growth are not possible. Then, why should I make the effort? Let me be as a disciple. Let me be as a bhakta itself. So in that itself, I am very satisfied. This shows you are lack of confidence. Even if you want to go to the temple, you should be confident enough to deal with the Ishvara. That's the absolute transaction. When you go to the temple, you have to speak with him. When you want to speak with him, you should not be like a beggar. A devotee who is in the form of beggar cannot gain anything. You have to be confident to be even a devotee. Then you can speak with, deal with Lord. Ishvara never help a person who doesn't have the confidence, who is endowed with inferior, so that inferiority makes him more inferior. Therefore, this is also a step. You have to be confident enough. And you also should use your free will to make your effort. When you want to buy a spectacles, you are going to a shop, the shopkeeper is showing so many spectacles, he is keep on changing, there you have to make a decision. So you make the decision, first you make that was not right, that was not appropriate, and again you changed, after changing 12 or 13 spectacles, you felt, you know, the first one was better. That fifth one was better, because our mind has the tendency to get fluctuated. That mind has to be organized. The doctor may give this prescription for your spectacles, but you become the selector, you become the chooser, you become the person who makes the decision. Therefore, we need to have a psychological system and the physical system which is healthier and which is contemplated, which has got the focusing capacity. That ability will help you to sit in the meditation properly. Therefore, Bhagavan Krishna in the beginning itself says that before sitting for the meditation, you should be clear with your goal and you should be thorough and be healthy with your systems. Then in this verse, that's what he says. So for him who has become mastery over his mind, is possible to maintain the mind with peaceful attitude. So that mind which is not shaken by mana apamana yoho shitoshna sukadukheshu. So physically he is also be firm and strong. No disease can affect him. No heat and cold will affect him. In the same way, psychological system also, it won't be shaken by honor or ignanimity. That's what the glory of a person who has become yoga rudaha. When he becomes yoga rudaha, that yoga rudaha is the eligible person for meditation. Now, that person who is endowed with this yoga rudhatvam is explained here. Jnana vijnana truttatma kotastha vichitendriyaha yukta ityuchate yogi samaloshtashma kanchanaha. Jnana vijnana truttatma. That person who is endowed with the knowledge of the Supreme, or knowledge of Nirguna Parabrahman. This knowledge of Supreme is being divided into two categories by our Shastra. One is known as Nirguna Parabrahman, another is known as Saguna Parabrahman. Nirguna Parabrahman means, that which is beyond all sense organs, that which is all pervasive, omnipotent, omnipresent, known as Brahman, or it is also called Atma. Saguna Brahman means Ishvara, who is endowed with Maya. It will be explained in detail in the 7th chapter. We can see there, we need not worry here. But the mind, Buddhi, which is endowed with the knowledge of the Supreme, though Saguna, Nirguna, Brahman, and also mind which is established in the Supreme Consciousness, Kutasthaha, the mind which cannot be shaken, the mind which is endowed with stability, Jitendriyaha, the Buddhi, by which he could get the mastery over, or it has got mastery over sense organs, Yuktaha Yityuchate, he is called meditator, yogi. And also he is mature enough, he could feel the similarity among the gold or diamond or the stone. The next words, Sukhrun Mitraryudasena Madhyasthadveshya Bandhushu Sadhushvapicha Papeshu Samabuddhirvicheshyate. Bhagavan Krishna is emphasizing more and more and more because the topic is very important. And also Sadhaka, the meditator here explained who is endowed with Brahma Jnanam, who has accomplished what to be accomplished. Now he is going to begin the meditation not to gain for anything, because whatever to be achieved, it has been achieved as Aham Brahmasmi. I am nothing but that Brahman. That Brahman is nothing but me. Even Ishvara I could feel in me. So I can find unanimity, means identification with Ishvara. Now he has got the content. That content must be contemplated in order to observe. That absorption to be taken place. For that, he is completely withdrawn person from the outside world. See, completely withdrawn person means he may perform the action. He may get engaged with so many activities, so many people. He may be engaged with the society. Completely he may seems to be a busy person, but he is not affected by any of them. That's what he is maintaining, that aloneness, not with loneliness. He may be among thousands of people. He could maintain his body, mind and sense complex. He could feel the privacy, because people, they are craving for the privacy, and they cannot be also alone. When they are not able to be alone, they cannot maintain the privacy among the thousands of people. But this person, if you keep him in the cave, or if you keep him among the people, he will maintain with proper peaceful mind. That's what the glory of this person known as Yuktaha, endowed with all the glories of the preliminary steps of yogas. Patanjali brings in the different way, yama, niyama, asana, pranayama, pratyahara, vantaha. One who has got succeeded with five steps, then he will be ready for dharana. Dharana means that is the antaranga sadhanani. That is serious vishesha sadhanani. Now in this words, Krishna just specifies it. He is equal with all the people. Sukrun, Mitra, Yudhasina. Because there are three kinds of peoples we face every day, we have to meet them. There may be well-wishers, Sukrastu, for us, who cares like mother, parents, friends. And all the friends may not care it with the special caring. Like the people who cares for us, with the friends, with Udasinaha, some people, you know, they don't worry about, they don't bother about us. They keep themselves their own space. If at all you are working in office, they don't bother. They don't care for your emotions. So whatever that official things to be done, to be transacted with you, they will do that much yourself. They don't bother. They don't even care for you. With them, and madhyastaha, madhyastha means in between people. Sometimes they come, they care with you, and sometimes they seems to be as the udasina. Udasina means bindaless, means the people, they don't worry for others. They don't care for others even. Dveshu and bandhushu, the people who hate you. With them, with the relatives, sadhushvapi, with the great souls, and with even the sinful people, samabuddhir visheshyate, he has the equal buddhi, means he is not affected by them and he doesn't want to affect them. He maintains his transaction as much as possible with complete awareness. Because he is endowed with Brahma Jnanam, we saw in the last chapter, Vidya Vinaya Sampanne Brahmane Gavi Hastini Shunishchaiva Swapake Cha Panditaha Samadarshanaha. The enlightened people, illumined people are having equal perception towards all difference among the beings. Finally, meditation is only transacting with myself and with my own world. It's a beautiful method given by Bhagavad Gita. The Krishna is excellent acharya, and he knows completely psychological aspects and physical aspects, because being Ishvara, he knows how to give. Now when you own the Brahma Jnana, that Brahma Jnana even with self-identification, after giving that alone, Bhagavan Krishna brings the topic of meditation. The next words, Yogi Yunjita Satatam Atmanam Rahasisthitaha Yekakiyata Chittatma Nirashira Parigraha. Now he says what to be done physically and how to go about meditation steps. Now he is just letting us know how to sit. Yogi satatam atmanam yunjite rahasisthitaha atmanam yunjite. We have to keep ourselves a little bit secret with our meditations. You need not propaganda that I meditate for 2 hours, 3 hours, 1 hour. You know that I get up early in the morning and do meditation. Don't let anybody to know your self-sadhana. Yogi yunjita. So yogi must be endowed with satatam atmanam rahasisthitaha. He has to have the self-secret, or he should maintain that individuality with the privacy, that he could spend the time. By that he could also be without any fluctuation. Yekaki etva chittatma nirashira parigraha. These words are very big. Yekaki, he should be alone, and there is no group meditation. Group meditation was in the beginning, now he has to be alone. So he has to be alone means what? Then alone you can deal with your all inner things. Yata chittatma, who has got mastery over the mind, nirashihi aparigraha, completely withdrawn from the outside world, not having any desire towards out. This shloka needs more understanding, that we will get from the next episode. See you. Harihi Om. Om Purnamadah Purnamidam Purnat Purnamudachyate Purnasya Purnamadaya Purnamevavashishyate. Om Shanti Shanti Shantihi. Harihi Om. Shri Gurubhyo Namaha. Harihi Om.